In previous class, we have seen linear regression. Today, let us see linear classifier. Classification is a task which identifies class or group an object belongs to based on object characteristics. Linear classifier achieves this by making classification decision based on the value of linear combination of features. Means classification algorithm that makes its predictions based on linear predictor function. Example of linear predictor function is, we have seen it in linear regression, y equal to wx plus b. Let us see the simplest binary classifier, perceptron, which is the first neural network developed by Frank Rosenblatt in 1958, which is inspired by earlier work of McCulloch and Pitts. This project was funded by US Office of Naval Research. Perceptron is an artificial neuron using step function as activation function, which is used for supervised learning for binary classifiers. Binary classifier decides whether particular input belongs to specific class or not. In perceptron, weighted sum of inputs passes through an activation function. Here it is step function. This weighted sum will be continuous values. Activation function maps this weighted sum of inputs to output of the neuron. Here it is 0 or 1. It is called as activation function because this function decides whether neuron should be activated or not, means whether neuron should be fired or not. Let us see how perceptron will work. Perceptron will take several inputs x0, x1, x2 and so on xn and produces single binary output y. In our case, here we have three inputs x0, x1, x2. These inputs will be multiplied with connection weights w0, w1, w2. These weights will express the importance of the respective input to the output y. The neuron's output 0 or 1 is determined by whether the weighted sum, this sigma wi xi, less than or greater than some threshold value. We can simplify this condition, summation wi xi greater than or less than or equal to some threshold value. First one, we can write this summation of wi xi as dot product of two vectors. Here weights w is one vector, inputs x is another vector. Then we can replace this portion with w dot x like this. And second one, move this threshold value to other side of the inequality and replace it by the perceptron bias. When this threshold comes this side, it will be minus threshold. So bias would be equal to minus of this threshold value. With these two modifications, we can rewrite perceptron like this. This bias is a measure of how easy it is to get the perceptron to output 1. Means bias is the measure to get the perceptron to fire. We can think of this perceptron as a method for weighing evidence to make decisions. Suppose if we have two inputs, perceptron space of our model will be 2D plane, x0, x1. Each input will be point on 2D plane. Neuron can be imagined as a hyperplane. In this case, it is straight line. In 2D, perceptron space. In this case, perceptron equation will be w0 x0 plus w1 x1 plus b equal to 0. x0, x1 are inputs and their respective weights are w0, w1, b is the bias here. Suppose if we have three inputs, perceptron space of our model will be 3D plane. Each input will be point on 3D plane. Neuron or perceptron can be imagined as hyperplane. In this case, hyperplane would be 2D plane. In 3D perceptron space, means this 2D plane will divide this 3D space into two parts. Then perceptron equation would be like this, w0 x0 plus w1 x1 plus w2 x2 plus b equal to 0. Let's see how perceptron can be used as model to learn logic function. Or here our training set, if inputs x0, x1 both are zeros, then output will be 0. In all other three cases, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, output will be 1. If we consider the input x0, x1 as point on the plane, corresponding output values plotted here, perceptron tells us to which region on the plane this point belongs to. The perceptron equation will be W0x0 plus W1x1 plus P equal to 0. If we rewrite this, x1 equal to minus W0 by W1 into x0 minus B by W1, which is in the form of straight line equation. Here we have two classes. This perceptron line W0x0 plus W1x1 plus P equal to 0 will divide plane into two regions. Suppose this is the class 0 and this is class 1. This perceptron line divides the plane into two regions, W0x0 plus W1x1 plus B less than or equal to 0. This is the region 1 or class 0, and another region W0x0 plus W1x1 plus B greater than 0, which is the second region or class 1. Suppose if we train the perceptron with training set data, W1 and W2 values are 0.5 and 0.5 and bias is minus 0.25. Then input 00 produces 0 multiplied with 0.5. Again this 0 will be multiplied with 0.5 minus bias value 0.25. The result is minus 0.25, which is less than 0. Means which is the negative value. So perceptron will produce the result 0. This is the first class. Similarly, for all other inputs 0 1 1 0 1 1, perceptron will produce 1s since all these values are positive. So with perceptron we can implement logic or function. Single layer perceptrons are only capable of learning linearly separable problems. For classification tasks, perceptron can perform single line to divide the data points. This kind of XOR function cannot be learned by drawing single line. So perceptrons cannot learn non-linearly separable patterns. In next class, we will see how to solve XOR problem, which is non-linear one.